What's up guys, welcome back to javaessential.com, and today we're going to look about the how to delete the duplicate character from any string in Java. In the last video, what we've seen was the print the duplicate character in any string. So let's see how to delete the duplicate character from the given string. This is our input string and we are going to delete the duplicate character from this string. To do this, we can implement it in by many ways, but here I'm going to explain you the two ways that I'm going to explain you the array list using the array list or using the set interface. What happen is, these are input string. Suppose whatever the input string will be there with us. What we have to do is, first we have to take the input string into a char array, so you can manipulate each character individually. So for this we have very great method that is provided by the Java, is a .toCharArray. What it does is, it will split your string into the character array. So after this, the manipulation into any characters is very easy. Mostly in any interview question, if you find the coding question based on the string, most of time you are going to use this toCharArray method. It is really very powerful and very useful to solve many questions. So let's start with the array list. How we are going to implement if we are using the array list. Suppose if you are using the array list, what we'll do is, we are splitting our each character here into the char array, and we'll took each character one by one and check whether this and we'll create, first we'll create one array list, and we'll check it, we'll take each character one by one and check whether this array list contains this character or not. If this array list doesn't contain this character, then we are adding that character. If this character is already present in that array list, then we'll discard this character, right? So this is the very basic fundamental for if you are using the array list. Check whether this character is already present or not. If it is already present there, discard it. If it is not present there in that array list, add it. That's it. And at the end, you will end up with the unique characters. So what you have to do is, just create a string buffer, a string builder, and append all those characters, and you will have one string which is having no duplicate characters. How you are going to implement the same thing if you are using the set interface? Like, if you are using the set interface, the property of the set interface is, it doesn't allow any duplicacy. So your job is very easy now here. In the array list, what you have to do is, you have to check whether the array list contains this character or not. But in the set interface, you don't need to do anything. It will be taken care of by the set interface itself. You just have to take each character from this character array. Just have to take each character from here and append, add into the char set. If it is that already present in that set, it will remove by default, because it won't allow duplication. So you don't need to do anything here. Okay, so that's the idea behind it. So if you want to use the array list, you can use the array list, or if you want to use the set interface, you can use the set interface. At the end, after creating the array without any duplicate character, you just have to create a string buffer or a string builder and append the unique characters there and return it. That's it. Let's start the coding of this. So first, what I have to create, we have to create a method which will return any string. I named it as remove duplicate. It will take any string. And just for the time being, I'm going to write this return statement as an str, because it will show an error if I'm not going to write this one. So what we have to do is, we just have to split this string into the char array. So what we'll do, we'll just create a char array with the name char arr is equal to str dot to, using the toCHAR method, we are going to split into the char array. And what we have to do is, we just have to create the set. I'm first explaining the set interface using the set interface. I just created the set character set with the name. Now here you have two options. either you can implement the hash set. Using the hash set, you can create a character set, or using the linked hash set. I'm going to use the linked hash set. Why? The reason is, you can ask why I'm going to use this one only. Then I will say, if you want to preserve the order of the element, then use. If you want to preserve the order of the element, then use the linked hash set. And if you don't care about the order of the element, then you can use hash set also. Here is the difference between the hash set and linked hash set. If you want to read it, just pause the video and go through it. Now what we have to do is, we just have to iterate through this char array. And what we have to do is, just have to add each character into char set. Char set dot add this ch. If there is duplicacy is present, set interface will take care. Set interface will take care of it. You don't need to worry about that. And after that, once the char set will be containing all the unique characters, what you have to do is, you have to create a string, because it is the what it is. It is something like a char array, but what you have to return is, you have to return the string, right? So you have to create one string buffer or string builder. And you just have to iterate through this char set this time, because these will contain what? This will contain the all the unique characters. And just append. SB.append. This C. That's it. So at the end, your SB will contain all the unique characters. And you just have to return this SB, because you can't return SB, string buffer. Here you have defined the string, you are going to return a string value. But if you are returning the string buffer, it will give an error. So what you have to do is, using the dot to string, you just have to convert your string buffer into a string. That's it, guys. So let's see what will be the output. Here is my input is here. And I just need to call this method here. Remove duplicate with our input string. Our input string is strng. So let's see what will be the output. Here I'm using the linked hash set. So definitely order is going to be preserved here. Whatever the input string will have the order, the same in the order, the output of this code will be in the same order. Here it is, ABCDEFZSW. Z is here, S is here, and W is here. Now if you use the hash set, what will happen? You can just check it out. Here it is, S comes in between, but where it is in our input string, S is somewhere in the last portion. So hash set is not going to maintain the order. So if you want to maintain the order, then use the linked hash set. Otherwise you can go with the hash set, because this will also give you the unique string, the unique characters present in that string. So that's it, guys. And if you want to see how we can do in the duplicate, how we can do using the string array, so here is the code, and you can just go through it. Just only one line you have to add, whether you just have to check by yourself that whether that character is containing in that string in that array list or not. So here is the code. You can just pause the video and just see. You can just run the code and you can go through it. It is very easy. So thank you, guys. Thank you for watching this video. And for more videos, please do subscribe. And I'm again saying that a few videos are only meant for the subscribers. So please do subscribe. Thank you, guys. Thank you for watching this video.